tutorial by NocoHQ. And today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up our live credit card preview plugin, which is published in the Bubble plugin store. And you can buy it under the publisher name Anticore, which is our no-code agency. And this is more of a bit advanced tutorial plugin to set up. So we just wanted to make a tutorial just to make your life easier and show you how to use this nice plugin. Just to explain what this plugin does, this displays a live and dynamic credit card preview, so something like this. And you can use your own inputs and style them whatever you like and tie them to this preview. So for example, here, if I click on expiry, this is automatically appended here, as you can see. If I click on CVC, this turns around, we can enter the CVC number. So really a beautiful beautiful UI, an interactive way to enter your credit card. This number here, whatever you input here, depends on if it's gonna display a Visa, MasterCard, and the color as well. I can enter the name here. So really a nice way to have a live preview. And what's also great is that this here is just a normal input. However, what this plugin does, it kind of grabs into this input and formats it in a way that we know an expiry can consist of maximum this number of integers. So I can't enter any more integers because obviously, or we can just have four digits here for the year. Same applies for the CVC. We can have maximum of four numbers. And here also the slash is automatically appended. I didn't enter that, so I'm just going to enter a six here and a zero. And then if we take a look at that, actually two should be work two and six. Yeah, now it works. So slash is automatically appended. So I'm just going to show you how to set this up. So I'm going to go back to my Bubble page here. This is the same page that we just looked at, just in the Bubble editor. I'm going to jump right into it. So we have this element here called card container. What you want to do is you want to search for that in the element tree, just select that, drag it onto your page, resize accordingly, but also keep in mind that you have to define the width here as well. So define the width here and also just resize it as you would normally. For the automatic formatting, you can define if these inputs should be automatically formatted as I showed you before. So if the slash should be appended, if the maximum CVC should be four digits. If you uncheck this box, a user can enter as many digits here as he wants. The slash won't be appended. So it depends on what you want, but you can try that out. And the placeholder is just here what will be displayed in the name field here if you don't have any text. Okay, so quite straightforward. Now to the more difficult part. What is great about this plugin is that you can define the inputs yourself. There's no predefined inputs that you have to use. And how we're going to do that. So what you want to do first, you just want to search for a group, okay? And you want to add a group to your Bubble page. We did already here. I called that input group, okay? And within this group, you kind of have to imagine this as a form group. And within this group, you want to have all the inputs that you want to that we want to use. So the credit card number, the expiry date, the CVC, and so on. So please make sure to create a group and drag all the inputs which I have here into this group. Now the important part, we have to tie in the plugin to these inputs. So how are you going to do that? First of all, we have this field here called form element ID, which is the element ID of the form you created. And the form is just this group. As you can see, I added the ID attribute form here. I could use something else, I could write anything, but make sure that whatever you enter here for this form group, you want to enter here as well, okay? And the same just applies for all the other fields here. So for our input credit card number, okay, I entered your number card because that's the element ID, the ID attribute I entered here. I can change that to CC input, okay? But now I have to copy that and input that here in the plugin under input credit card number. So just create any ID attributes. They have to be different, okay? So they have to be unique within your whole page, but create any unique ID attributes, okay? And then copy that. So if you want the user to enter the expiry date here, enter an ID attribute, copy that, and paste it here under the relevant input element ID. And that's basically it. So relatively straightforward, but maybe a bit confusing for the first time. So as you can see, I just changed that here, CC input. We did that together. Just let's preview that and see if it works now. There should be no difference if we did everything correctly. So let's just wait until this loads up. this loads a bit slow because we have a lot of plugins here in this preview app. So yeah, we did it for a number. So I'm just gonna enter one here. As you can see, we already know it works. Let me enter a 4. It knows it's a Visa. Let's enter a 5 or a 8, 7, 2, 1. I forgot what MasterCard is, but yeah, as you can see, it works. No issues, just make sure that the input element ID matches the field in the plugin element. So yeah, that's basically it, quick tutorial. I wish you good luck setting this up and have fun showing this to your users.